Okay, assalamualaikum and very good morning. Okay, today we will continue with our next lecture. Okay, on the which is lecture number 5. Okay, this is for the single degree of freedom force damped variations. For the case of we have the forcing from the base excitation or rotating angular mass. Okay. So later on, you will be given a group reports, okay, which including on these two items, okay. Okay, so basically for the force vibration, okay, basically on the theoretical, for this we just learn on the forcing force, but actually it can be induced from the rotating angular mass, okay. For example, you have a motor and angular mass, which is give you a very uncertain disturbance, and also from the base excitation. Okay, for example, what I have introduced to you before this, when you drive a vehicle or going to the rough roads, there will be a base excitation force. Okay. Okay, so this is basically on previous one. Okay, where we have known on the direct forcing. Okay. Where the force is equal to F naught cosine omega t, but for the base excitation, okay, is from the base displacement and velocity, and for the unbalanced mass is from the small unbalanced mass, okay, which include another mass to the system. Okay, so for the rotating unbalanced mass, okay, this is basically the unbalance in a rotating machinery. Okay, and it's one of the cause of the vibration lah. Okay, for example, in our daily life, okay, we use the washing machine, okay, the lathe, the CNC machine that you have experienced before, okay, which also induce a unbalanced mass. Vehicle tires, okay, that's why we need to do a alignment and balancing, so that's it can neutral back the balance of the vehicles. And of course, for the turbines, okay, fan and rotor blades that were basically in the helicopter, for example, okay. Okay, this is a theoretical model of the structure, okay, system that have the unbalanced mass. Okay, so basically, you have the M is for the total mass. Okay, so the M is total mass is including the also the unbalanced mass, okay. The M, small m, is the rotating unbalanced mass, okay, this one, okay. K is the stiffness, okay. C, damping, okay, the usual one. E is the eccentricity, which is the radius distance from the center to the center of the unbalanced mass. Omega is the angular speed, okay. And XT is the position, okay, or which is the movement of the part lah, okay. Okay, so basically, okay, as you know before, we have a system, okay, which is including the mass, okay, so we have the stiffness and damping, okay, so we have the motions, okay. Okay, for the forcing one, okay, basically we in this system we have additional of okay of the unbalanced mass, okay, M, this is E, this is small m, okay, and also the rotating angle speed lah, okay. So as usual, we can basically all this one you already learned, okay, is on the plus and minus part, okay, we have the on the we have the force, okay, and also this one is so the motions, this one is k and minus c, yeah. So basically it's the same formulation that finally you get mx double dot plus cx plus kx equal to ft, okay. But for this one, okay, the force is for the FT, okay, it can be detailing as M omega ME omega the power of 2 sine WT. Okay, this is basically the F naught lah. Okay, F naught equal to MA, and A is the what we call it a radial acceleration equal to E omega the power of 2. Okay, so since the horizontal movement is constrained, okay, we will only consider the vertical one, okay, the x, okay, so the equation motion can be written as this lah, okay. Okay, the M, this is the big M, okay, the big M, okay, mx double dot plus cx plus kx equal to ft, eh? So ft equal to me omega the power of 2 sine omega t, eh? Okay, so the problem is similar to the force damper vibration that we have seen in the previous lecture, only the form of external forcing force, which is magnitude, is different, lah, which is F naught equal to MA, where MA is E omega the power of 2. Therefore, we can use the same technique to obtain the amplitude and the phase angle, lah, by assuming this trial function, okay, XT A sine omega T minus phase. Eh? Okay, so I rewrite the equation of motion in this form of omega n and damping ratio, we can obtain this equation lah, okay. So this is, you can refer back how we can get until this stage. Okay, so since we only consider the steady state solution of the response just like before, okay, so the amplitude is given by this lah, okay. You refer back to equation number 37 in the previous slide, okay, so that you can know that we have a displacement of this lah, okay, and also the static deflection and natural frequency. Okay, so by replacing and have a some state of derivation, finally we can get this equation lah for the case of rotating unbalanced mass. Okay, okay, where at the back part, okay, we have a most similar one, but in the front part, okay, we have the element of rotating unbalanced mass. Okay. So since the frequency ratio omega divided by omega n, so we can have a more simplified form lah. This is basically the final equation lah. Okay, so by expressing the phase, for the phase between the excitation and response is given by theta, okay, tangent minus 1, okay, 2 damping ratio r, okay, divided by I minus r the power of 2. This is actually the similar one for the phase as a previous equation lah. Okay, this is actually can be manipulated when you move the M here and ME, so you can find the form on this. This is basically for you to plot the graph. Okay, so what happened to the amplitude if there is no damping in the system? So we can find out, we can delete the damping here. This is the final equation lah, if you want to plot it. But basically, for the system which the unbalanced mass is a damping is a must lah. Okay, unless the system will be very disturbed. Okay. Okay, so we can see here. Okay. Okay, this is the response. Okay, you can have a. Okay. Okay, at the curve begin for all the curve is beginning at the zero amplitude lah. Okay. Okay, because when you insert the is because it have the value of r here, okay, okay, when there is no excitation force, okay, there will be a zero. So different from the previous typical damped system, it will start with number is value of static deflection of 1, but with the rotating unbalanced mass, it will start with value of 0. Okay, so the as usual, when the excitation frequency equal to natural frequency is going to the resonance, yeah, this is the resonant area. When as usual, if you added the damping, the peak will be reduced. Okay, the higher the damping element, the lower the peak will begin. This is example of the critical damped system, the most ideal condition. You can see the response is good enough, eh? So the amplitude near resonant is marked affected by the damping lah. So the damping should be introduced purposely to avoid dangerous amplitude at resonance, because it's a rotating unbalanced mass. So is we give a more higher force to the system. At a very high speed, okay, light speed is almost unity. Okay, there's no effect of the damping and also the excitation frequency, and most of the value will go into unity, where the amplitude will become a static deflections. Okay. Okay, at this stage, the effect of damping can be neglected. Okay. Okay, this example. Okay, I will show you one of the example here. This is more on the washing machine. You can refer after this, but this one is on the helicopter. Okay, you can see, some of the moments that it start to become very unbalanced, and if we broke all the structure, this is how they do the testing for the helicopter before they implement it to show how worse the condition of the rotating ambient mass. Okay, so this is very dangerous, basically, because it can broke all the structure. Okay. Okay, so for that, okay. Okay, this is basically all the summary lah, okay, where there's a lot of parameters in the system. Okay, and this is equation of motion, okay, as explained before. Okay, the trial function, which is basically different for each of the cases, and finally we find out the amplitude to plot this graph. Okay, so basically if you have three different value of damping ratio or two different value of excitation frequency, you can basically roughly plot the response. Okay, next is our system for the base excitations. Okay, so in many of application, dynamic system can be subjected to the base excitation lah. Okay, so a machine operate in the factory is affected by the vibration of other machine lah. For example, when you do a machining at the workshop, okay, so basically you do a turning, for example, it's not basically based on if affected by the rotating ambient mass, but it's also affected by besides, okay, the other machine. Okay, for example, you conducting this machine and the machine from this will transfer to the floor and giving the excitation base. Okay, so that's this a double disturbance. Okay, another example of base excitation is earthquake. Okay, this is very familiar one. Okay, so the building response, the car suspension also can fall into these categories. Okay, when you drive to the different road profiles. Okay, as explained before. Okay, different from the harmonic force acceleration, excitation is from the base. Okay, and it can be in terms of displacement or velocity. Okay, so this is the example, the mass, okay, the stiffness and the damping. Okay, so for the x, okay, you have to find the response, but for the y is the base motion, basically it's known lah, or if it's unknown we can measure it. Okay, and of course we have to consider it as a massless, no mass for the base. Okay, so as usual you can derive it. Okay, so for the base excitation, basically we have also the similar one, the M, okay, the damping, and also the, so basically for this one, okay, the excitation force we have from the base. So basically the base, we consider that this is as a fixed condition. But for this one, we can put it as a floating one. The YT is the excitation base. So this can be divided as usual, plus minus. Okay, so for this one you have a X and K and C at the minus part. Okay, so the total is F equal to MA. So for the minus part, actually you can have the K, okay, X, the plus one, minus by Y, also minus C, x dot plus y dot. Okay, this is similar to this, okay, where you have the minus k, of course k the below part, and then you take the upper part x minus by y, okay, and also the same as the c is at the below part minus c, x dot minus by y dot. Okay, so finally you will get the equation of motion, okay, same as the question number 46, which is mx double dot plus cx plus kx, and you separate all this y, okay, left and the right, so there you get the cy dot plus ky. So this is actually the considered as a excitation force in term of displacement and velocity. Okay, so basically you can given the yt, okay, the excitation displacement, okay, y sine omega t, okay, and of course you can insert to this equation, okay, you can differentiate y to y dot, okay, you can get the from sine you can get the cosine, okay, this is the velocity one as usual lah. You can do the differentiate, and then of course we have also the xt, okay, the trial function, okay, for the this part, okay, x sine omega t minus by theta, so that you can get this final form, okay. So this is what we call it, okay, you rearrange back x divided by y and you get the final equation. This is called the displacement transmissibility, okay. Why we call this displacement? Because x is displacement, y is displacement, okay, mean that the input is displacement and the output also the displacement. So this is basically the ratio, so you can calculate the ratio output over input lah. This is the same like transfer function, how many the input you given to the system and how much the output will be. So basically when we get the value of 1, basically what we give in the input is similar to the output, but if the value is more than 1, so that the condition is worse lah. The system is worse, meaning that the output generate more disturbance compared to the input. So basically what we want to be our value of displacement must be below than 1, and the theta is as a specific value also, so that you can using these two to plot the graph. Okay, so for this one, okay, this is the basically the single degree freedom based excitation. Okay, x over y is the displacement transmissibility ratio, tells how motion is transmitted from the base to the mass, okay, which the various excitation frequency lah. Okay, as usual the same, okay, when you can plot at the when the excitation frequency is zero or small, okay, towards the resonance, and finally on the higher frequency excitation. Okay, this is the case of we have the undamped, okay, where the damping ratio is below than 1, you can the higher the damping as usual, the lower the amplitude at the resonance. Okay, and we can see this one is more clear, okay, where we plot the different types of the damping, starting from the undamped, the small one, until the higher one, and we get a critical damped, okay, the most ideal one lah. Okay, so this is basically different from the rotating ambient mass, okay, where we can have the value of 1 here, okay, okay, because if you insert the value of r equal to 0, you can still get the value of 1, because we have 1 here. Okay, so and then go into the resonance, okay, where r equal to 1, okay, and the special case of the transmissibility is that all the points will be cross, okay, whatever the value of the damping ratio or excitation frequency, when r equal to the square root of 2, all the points will have the amplitude of 1. Okay, so this is the basically the theory part lah. Okay, so you can try it by inserting the value of r equal to the square root of 2 and using the varies of the damping ratio value, but you still get the value of 1. Okay. Okay, so for this one is the 6, okay, fixed rules for the base excitation system. Okay. Okay, you can see, you can compare back to this graph. Okay. Okay, when the value of transmissivity TD is unity, okay, at R equal to 0, okay, the value of TD is unity, is equal to 1 at R equal to 0 and close to unity when the R value is small. Okay, for the undamped system, when the damping ratio is equal to 0, okay, so TD is resonant lah, okay, as usual lah, where there is no damping, there will be a resonant, the value is infinity lah, okay, at R equal to 1 for the undamped, but if you include the damping system, it's starting to reduce in amplitude lah, okay, so the value of transmissivity is less than unity, okay, below than 1 for the value of R is bigger than square root of 2 lah, you can see after it's across the R equal to square root of 2, then the value is below than 1, okay, which means that after this, after the value of R equal to, the transmissivity is good lah, is below than 1 lah, then any of damping will slightly affected it, but the value that you will get is still then below than 1, which means that the transmissivity is good lah, okay. So the value of TD is unity for all the value of damping ratio equal R equal to the square root of 2 lah, okay. At the what I have said before, whatever the damping value at the R equal to square root of 2, the value of amplitude is 1, okay. Of also for the R below than square root of 2, okay, here the smaller the values of damping ratio lead to larger, okay, mean that if the damping ratio is not sufficient, the amplitude will be large, okay, but it's opposite when it's cross the value of the power root of 2, the smaller the damping ratio leads to the smaller TD, okay, this is basically the 6 rules that you have to understand, okay. Okay, this is in terms of phase angle, okay, when you use the equation given, then you can also plot the response, okay, somewhat similar when you increase the damping ratio, okay, the phase angle also will be different, okay. Okay, so this is the sum of question that maybe can test you, okay. So give the differences between the single degree of freedom with rotating unbalanced mass and base excitation. Okay, what is the difference between if you have these two plots? Okay, so type of disturbance, for example. Okay, what is the type of disturbance for the rotating unbalanced mass and what is the type of disturbance for the base excitation? The vibration amplitude at zero or small excitation frequency, you can refer back to the graph. Okay. How the response will be at the small excitation frequency, and the effect of damping at frequency ratio of square root of 2, okay, and then you can compare back, is it the damping element affect the both system or just one system, okay. Okay, this is another transmissivity results, okay, where you have another equation here, okay, where this is the where you have the input in terms of displacement but the output in terms of force, okay, the transmissivity can be anything, it can be input of velocity, output of force, input of acceleration, output of velocity, then the it will come up with a different equation lah, but for your level basically we are more targeting on the displacement transmissivity, this is not just on the add-on one, okay. So by refer to this graph, you can compare back all these 6 rules before this for the displacement transmissibility. Is it the same rules can be used for the force transmissibility? So by comparing this graph to the previous graph, so that you can make a conclusion. Okay. Okay, this is how we have a base acceleration in terms of displacement transversality. Yeah? Okay, where when we have the excitation here, okay, is toward the static deflections and the resonance, of course, when R equal to 1, natural frequency is same as the excitation frequency, and when the value is too high, is toward a zero value. Eh? Okay. Okay, so you can refer back to this graph. Okay. Okay, starting from 1 to resonant and towards a zero values. Okay. So this is just an animation. We can see that compared to the previous animation, this one is, you can see the base is moving. Eh? Okay. Okay, now we come to the final part, which is on the summary of the base acceleration. Okay, this is the free body diagram. Okay, the equation of motion. Okay, this is the forcing in terms of velocity and displacement, the trial function for the base, and also the response, the equation of motion. Finally, we can get the transmissibility and also the phase angle. Okay, this is the graph that you can plot from this. Okay, so we go to this example. Okay, we can show you. Okay, so for this one, okay, a diagram shows a motor vehicle that can oscillate in the vertical direction. Eh? Okay, there's directions while traveling to over the uneven roads. Okay, this is the roads. The vehicle weight Km equal to 1200 kg. The suspension system has a spring constant K of 400 kN per meter, and damping ratio 0.5 is under damped condition. If the vehicle speed velocity equal to 220 km/h, determine the displacement amplitude. You want to find the x of the vehicle. The road surface varies sinusoidally with the amplitude of y. It's given y equal to 0.05 meter. And the wavelength of 6 meter, which is starting from here to one of complete cycle, is have the wavelength of 6 meter. Okay, so how to solve it? Okay, let's see the example. Okay, so you can use the omega equal to pi f. Okay, where f is actually 1 over t. Okay, so for this is you must get the result of unit of 1 over second lah. Okay, so basically you have to think more creatively how you can get the solution lah. Okay, so you have given the velocity where it can be converted to the unit of meter per second, and also you have given the wavelength where the unit can convert to the meter lah. Okay, so from this you can cancel out the meter, and then you can get the unit of 1 over s lah. So you can have the value of acceleration frequency. Okay, so for the velocity here and omega, so you can also get the natural frequency. The kmn is given so that you get the now you have already the omega and omega n lah. Okay, so as usual you can directly get the frequency ratio, and finally you can insert to this equation. Now you have the damping ratio is given 0.5, the r is calculated, and also you can have the result of transmissibility lah. Okay, since the acceleration base acceleration amplitude is given by 0.05, so that you can also get the response of x. Okay, so from this you can have a conclusion that this indicates that the 5 cm of bump, in the roads is transmitted to 5.5, means that the transmissibility you can see is 1.1. So it's worse, it means that when you give the acceleration displacement of 5 cm, the mass of the system is vibrate at 5.5 cm. So the transmissivity is over than 1, so it's not a good design of a system. Okay, so let's see the next example. Okay, it's on the rotating unbalanced mass. Okay, for the unbalanced electric motor, is mounted on the plastic table. Okay, we have a table, for example, here. So we have a motor, and we have the rotating unbalanced mass here lah. Okay, the weight of the table plus the motor is 5 kg. Yeah, so the total M, the big M is 5 kg. The unbalanced part of the motor have a mass of the small M, 0.5 kg, located at 0.1. The E from the motor rotating axis, the damping ratio is 0.06 under dampened. Okay, natural frequency Fn is not omega n, you have to convert. And estimate the amplitude of the steady state displacement, find the x. Okay, assuming the excitation frequency is, this is omega, 188.5 radian second. So you have the value of m, e, omega by omega n. You can have the solution of these two. Okay, the big M, also the R, you have get it. The damping ratio also is given. So basically, it's just a direct replacement of the value. You can get the answer. Okay, so the next one is on the, it's almost similar, okay, to the question number 3, but this one you have to think a little bit, okay, on how to solve it. Okay, so this one I will let you try first. Okay, do your use of activity, but it's still the same. You have to use this final equation. Okay, all most of the parameters is given, and how you can solve it. Okay, using this the stiffness constant. Okay, where you can use to determine all the parameters lah, such as the natural frequency. Yeah. Okay, I think that's all for today. Okay, thank you very much for listening. Okay.